Up the Academy, released June 6th, 1980. Alternative title, The Brave Young Men of Wienberg. Some interesting filming locations also. Jenny's Liquor on 11989 West Old Highway 40. This was produced by Warner Brothers. Ran 87 minutes and it was rated R and it was crazy. For maybe my generation, I was an 80s kid. And I remember seeing this and remembering Ralph Macchio when I saw him later in Crossroads, which I'm sorry is better than The Karate Kid. Crossroads, shout out. So this is kind of a comedy cross between Animal House and Police Academy, where all these kids are sent to this military academy for different reasons, and craziness ensues. And I do know one of the guys has a girlfriend. I'll have to find her name. She is super hot. She's in this. So her name is Stacy Nelkin. She played Candy in the movie, and she was damn hot. Very curvaceous. Speaking of curvaceous, Barbara Bach, she played Bliss, or Miss Bliss, I forget how they said it, but any questions? I remember that from my childhood. Leonard Frey played the Commandant. Say it again. Leonard Frey played the Commandant. Say it again. Anyway, that was his thing. He was so good, so creepy. Wendell Brown played Ike. Tommy Satira played Hash. Ralph Macchio played Cooch. I'm not sure how they pronounced it. That was the beginning of his whatever. I just watched it again the other night just to remind myself. I don't think I've seen it since, maybe once since the 80s. So anyway, Mad Magazine produced it or had whatever to do with it. Robert Downey produced it, not Junior, but Senior. Robert Downey Jr. was one of the boys on the soccer team down on the field at the end of the movie. So that's kind of interesting. Bernie Brillstein, executive producer, on and on and on. But just a good old wacky comedy from the... I'm an 80s kid, so that's why this one's so fun. So the first track is Kicking Up a Fuss by Blowout. Words and music by Jody Wirth and Bruce Nicholson. This is a cool song just because it was the transition from Sex Pistols, Ramones punk to the new 80s, more, you know... kind of Elvis Costello, Boomtown Rats thing. But, you know, still a cool song, but not too overproduced. But it gets you that vibe of being super young and just like, cool track, keeps the movie moving. Next we got Gimme Danger by Iggy Pop and James Williamson, performed by the Stooges in 1973. It's so odd that it starts out with acoustic, but it's kind of cool. So live. After listening to music for the last 20 years made on a computer, it's a trip to hear this stuff just so live. But another cool tune. Next we have Trying to Find My Baby by the Dwight, Twilley Band. Say that three times fast. 1977 from the album Twilley Don't Mind. Definitely more pop, almost Bay City Rollers or something, but who cares? It's a movie and it's 80. Next we have Ex-Offender by Blondie, 1976, from their first album. Cool tune. This was definitely the 80s coming into play. Up-tempo, female vocals like the Go-Go's and all that stuff. Really cool tune. And you can see where Blondie was headed to. Next we have Do Anything You Wanna Do by Eddie and the Hot Rods. It sounds like a 50s band, but that was actually 77. Another cool up-tempo tune, just, you know, teenaged angst. You're going to get out and go out on Friday night, do the things you do when you're that age. Super cool. Just all, again, real tracks played live. Lots of guitar. Lots of energy. Super cool. Next we have Yes Sir, No Sir by the Kinks, 1969. That's the weird thing about this movie. They didn't really do a lot of fresh stuff. A little bit with Blondie and such, but they went back in time for a lot of this stuff also. But this one sounds like the Grateful Dead to me or something. I was surprised it was the Kinks. Very jammy sounding. But I don't even remember where this was in the movie, but it's on the list. Next is We Gotta Get Out of Here by Ian Hunter. And I think, what's the guitar player's name from Bowie? Mick Ronson was involved in this one. this was definitely when punk was going new wave, and things were changing in a more poppy feel, which was cool for me because you could actually remember the song at that point, at least the hook. But yeah, kind of poppy, new wavy, good stuff. Next we have Street Hassle by Lou Reed, 1978. And get ready, everybody, to hate me, because I was never a Lou Reed fan, especially whatever that band that he came from, Velvet Underground. But he's come up with a few good songs, and this one's decent. I like the cello. That's probably the best part of the song. So, moving on. Next, we have Roadrunner by Jonathan Richman and the Modern Lovers. It says here 76, but when I watch the video, it says 72, so I have no idea. It's proto-punk. Kind of sounds more like the Kinks than the Kinks do in this movie. But it's got that, you know, raucous attitude of teenage angst again, which is just cool. All live, you know, bare bones garage type recording, but awesomeness nonetheless. Next we have Rat Trap by the Boomtown Rats, Bob Geldof, who actually did a lot with his voice. They always had creative hooks and melodies and arrangements of their songs. You know, they always have piano breakdowns and it was never boring. So I always liked that band. This is 1978 and another up-tempo teenage angst, gotta get out of this town kind of thing, but definitely a cool song for this movie. Next we have Girls by David Johansen. And I guess Sylvain was involved. I dig this tune because it's straight to the point. A tribute to girls and women, and you know, a good thing. And this is after he left the New York Dolls and went out on his own, so good stuff. Next we have One Way or Another by Blondie. Two songs on this soundtrack for them, and what do I need to say about this? This is entrenched in my memory as a kid. That opening guitar riff, that chromatic descending line. It's from the Parallel Lines album, 1978. So I guess I was wrong saying their other album was their first, 1980. So next we have, I can't even pronounce it, Coquette, I'll just not even try, by Cheeks, written by Gary Wagner. Another up-tempo, new wavy punk song coming into the 80s. The drummer is going off on this song. I'm surprised that he was allowed to get away with it, which I'm joking. Playing real drums, you can do whatever you want, and he is just going off on this one. Next we have Local Hero by Blow Up. Words and music, Jody Wirth and Bruce Nicholson. Another kind of mid-tempo, teen angst thing, kind of similar to the rest, but, you know, fits in this movie for sure. Next we have Bad Reputation by Sammy Hagar, the king of movie soundtracks. This is from the album Danger Zone in 1979, and I love Sammy. Yeah, I'm a Dave fan for Van Halen, but that doesn't mean you can't like Sammy and in Van Halen or all the other shit he's done. Especially now with the tequila and when he opened up his club in the Cabo Wabo. I mean, the guy's just always moving, always working, always doing something. I love that. Big inspiration. Next we have Night Theme by Iggy Pop and James Williamson from the Kill City album, 1973. I have no idea what's going on with this one either. There's still a lot of acoustic guitar in it, though. Next, we have Boney Moroney by The Cheeks again. Music and words by Larry Williams. Another up-tempo, teenaged Friday night awesomeness track. Next, we have Heart of the City by Nick Lowe from the album Pure Pop For Now People, 1978, and it is pure pop. Three chords, anti Zeppelin and Yes and all that stuff. They were going to town on this. But up-tempo, good pop, good vocal. Perfect for this movie. Next we have We Live for Love by Pat Benatar and Neil Giraldo. Of course, he was awesome for guitar work on this song and all the other songs and half the LA albums back in the day, too. Rick Springfield, etc. From the album In the Heat of the Night, 1979, the production on this record is so far above the rest of the tracks on this soundtrack, it's kind of funny. Next, we have Midnight Rendezvous by The Babies, John Waite and Jonathan Cain on the writing action before Journey. Classic song. This is one of the few songs I didn't mind doing in my cover band because that opening riff is killer. And then it goes right into the straight you know, do, which I've always liked. That's why I liked Priest and all that shit. And his voice is killer. So, like the Pat Benatar album, the production on this is definitely above and beyond the rest of the... Next, we have Surrender by Cheap Trick, one of my all-time favorite bands. In Color and Black and White, Dream Police, and Heaven Tonight. All perfect albums, all in a row. Just genius. Before, you had to always have a hit song. It was just awesomeness. But anyway, Surrender, the classic, killer. Nothing else to say. But Robin Zander's voice, completely underrated. Punk, new wave, rock, pop, rockabilly, whatever you want to say. He can do it all. And last but not least, Beat the Devil by Blow Up. Jody Wirth and Bruce Nicholson wrote it. I do love the snotty, I don't know if they're English, but that snotty English vocal. It's because you're young and you don't give an F. And there's no worry or fear anywhere in your thought process. But anyway, that's the soundtrack to Up the Academy. Great movie. I mean, like I say, if you weren't there, it's not probably great. But if you were there, or even a kid, or your older brother, or whatever, and you want to go back in memory lane, I'll leave a link to the YouTube, because this is all over YouTube as far as just the songs go. And go back in time and have fun.